From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
And I'm Erin O'Valley. A big tax break is on the way for Thompson's Point here in Portland.
City Council approved a plan to cut new taxes on the $100 million development by almost half. News 8's Dave Guthrow has the details for us.
Well, it's a project that's caused a lot of buzz around Maine. And last night, another big step towards coming to fruition as the city council approved that $31 million 30-year tax break for the Thompson's Point development project. Now, 54% of the $58 million in new taxes will be returned to the development, while the city will retain 46% of the taxes. Developers have cited the need for the tax break to cover costs due to marine clay and rail crossing on the site. The $100 million project will feature a 100,000-square-foot conference center, a parking garage, a hotel, two office buildings, and other facilities, plus an express bus with stops at the Jetport, the Maine State Pier, and the Thompson's Point development will be funded by that tax money set to be returned to the city. Now, the developers are hoping that demolition could start as soon as this fall, and developers also saying that initial building construction could start in early 2012. And, of course, we'll have the latest details as they become available on our website, WMTW.com. For now, at City Hall in Portland, I'm Dave Guthrow for News 8.
All right, Dave, thanks so much. Dave also told us that last night the Portland City Council approved the city's new graffiti ordinance, but not before making some major changes to it. Council removed a proposed $100 fine for property owners, and it would have been applied to anyone who did not try to remove the graffiti within 10 days. Many property owners called it unfair, saying it would be punishing the victim. The ordinance goes into effect in 30 days. The developer of a proposed strip club in Elliott will go before the town's planning board tonight, just days after residents voted to place some pretty tough restrictions on adult entertainment businesses in town. Town officials tell News 8 that Donald D'Annunzio submitted an application for the club months ago, but has not yet been approved by the planning board. Now, over the weekend, Elliott residents approved several ordinances banning full nudity and alcohol sales, as well as prohibiting a strip club from operating between midnight and 6 a.m. The ordinances took effect immediately.
Well, after a day of helping build houses for Habitat for Humanity, 35 young adults will be heading off on a cross-country bike trip today. The group represents Bike and Build Incorporated. It's a national nonprofit organization committed to affordable housing. They will be biking from Portland to Santa Barbara, California, raising money for Habitat for Humanity. Now, along the way, they'll be stopping to help at 12 building projects. The group began their effort helping on a home here in Freeport. Three of the bikers in the group are from Maine, including the Brady twins from Kennebunk.
And everybody's the same age, same stage in life, so everybody's really like-minded and stuff like that. So that's how I got involved, and I convinced Rob.
And tomorrow, we dip our back tires in the Atlantic Ocean, and we get to Santa Barbara, we'll dip our front tires, kind of a symbolic kind of thing, so should be fun.
Well, the Bike and Build group expects to finish up their trek in California on August 27th. The program has raised nearly $3 million for affordable housing projects since 2003, and we wish them a safe journey.
We sure do.
And thanks for tuning in to this News 8 Now update. I'm Erin O'Valley.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Stay with us. Your forecast and sports highlights coming right up. Happy summer, everyone.